Hello everyone, my name is Chanuel Isondra and today I'm going to teach you how to paint this wonderful landscape painting. So today I'm going to paint another landscape with some trees there, some grasses, some fields, and I'm not sure if I'm going to put animals there, but maybe I'll try. And please don't forget to subscribe, if you subscribe it and hit the bell button if you want to receive some future notifications on my new videos and tutorials. Okay, you can see all the materials here on the screen. Consider the 5 limited colors, the brushes that we need, and all the things that we need to paint this painting. Okay, so we're gonna start now. Okay, so I'm gonna do a little sketching first. I have here the raw umber. And I'm gonna try to put a little bit of a steep field here, or a little mountain, and also here. Few trees there, and on the back here would be some forest, and my light will be in the top part, something like that here, and I'm gonna put a big tree here, huge tree here, something like that, to cover that part. Okay, so this is my plan, and I'm going to start now. Maybe here I will try to put some water. A little bit of water here, maybe. It would be great. Okay, that's it. So let's start now. It's just very, very easy landscape to do one. I always want to put some easy landscape, but I'm gonna put details there to make it look a little bit hard, but more advanced for the beginners, so beginners will learn more. So I have here a big pass. I don't know what happened, it turns black. I put it on the water for a long time. Actually, I didn't paint for more than 1 week. So I have here something like white and blue, a little bit of blue color. I don't want to put in so much blue in the sky. I don't want. Just a little bit of white and blue. I want the sky to be very, very bright, because this is because the light is on top. It looks good. And then I have here the blue and the red, a little bit of amber, and then white. It's just too much blue, everyone. Add more red, a little amber. It should be look more gray, yes. Grayish light or something like that. Yeah, I need some white on my palette. I have a white. whites on this finish. So first thing, sapphire is the one. We have here some blue, red, and a little umber. And white. There. I'm sweating. Colors a little bit of gray, yes everyone, that's good. Get a bit of Paris on the back. A bit of white here because this is a water. And in here, I'm gonna try to put some greenish blue and a bit of yellow. Don't worry everyone, this is still the underpainting. A little bit of umber. Some yellow. Okay, that's very solid colors everyone. And then also here in the bottom part. A little bit of red and yellow. That's good colors. Strong. A little bit of lumber here to make it dark. So here, I'm gonna make it a little bit blue because this is what this part will be a little bit of water. So I'll just cover this one with greenish color. There you go. I don't know if this is right. Yeah, I'll just let it dry first before we're gonna start adding some more details. Okay everyone, so I think the paint's already wet. I'm going to start adding the details now. So I will start here first on this part, and I'm going to do the details there. I'm gonna try to add some trees, details on the trees or something like that. And yeah, I'm gonna do my best to make it as realistic as possible. I'm gonna do my best to put a lot of details there just to make it look good. Okay, so I'll be using this bristle flat brush. I don't know, I lost one of my piece of flat brush. Maybe I need to buy some more. Okay. So, I have here some blue and yellow. A little bit of amber. And then white. More blue. Make it much bluish, everyone. That's too much dark. I'm gonna put some white there. There, do it a little bit of circulars. Or we can make it a little bit lighter. Just a tapping technique. Let's put some grasses here tonight. Okay, as you can see now, there's a lot of trees there. Let me just put more. There you go. Make sure, everyone, some tips. Make sure that your highlights must be lighter than the background. So I just add white if you think that it's still light enough, that it's not that you cannot see any highlights there. So just add white. That is one, it's not dropping, the color is dropping again, so I need to add. Yeah, that's the problem with the actors, especially the student grades. The colors always drop, it becomes darker. And it's pretty normal with the acrylics. I'll try a little bit of yellow and then white. You can also put a little bit of yellowish. There, as you can see now, there's a lot of trees. So, can observe that that part of one is a harvest, but I like the color. It's very, very bright. It looks good. It looks very. It looks. There's a light in the back of it that it's misty. It looks misty. So, yeah, it looks great. So I like that. I like the effect on that. Background there, the background forest. Okay, so I'm going to put a tree here to be a huge tree. But first, I'm gonna lighten this part. I want to make it look like there's great light hitting that part. So I'll try some orange, yellow, and red and white. I'll try more like orange, yellow, and red. This will be some kind of a yellow field. So I am using the same brush, the Bristol flat brush. Let's try yellowish. Yeah, just stop it, technically, everyone. Just like that. Just drag it down like that. And then I'll try. Technique. looks very, very bright. Another yellow. Also here. So to put some little bit of orange. But this time, this part would be not so much. A little bit of orange. I'll try to put one big tree there. I like to put a really big tree, that's my plan for one. To make it look, there's a big tree there. I want the tree to be dark, something like that here. It would be really huge. Okay. So, I will try to use this bristle flat, this brush. Bristle flat brush. It's a nylon flat brush. So we're gonna mix for dark color, blue and the red, and then yellow, or you can see, use the umber, blue and the red. Create now start adding, making some details of the tree, some tree leaves or something. Yeah, I want it to be thick and dark, so the same color.
I'll try to put some tree trunk. Here, everyone. So this is gonna be a huge big tree. Okay, let's cover everything. Oh, wait, I'm going to put some tree trunk, everyone. I'm gonna use this small brush. Number two. Okay, it's gonna be a big tree, everyone. And then, let's not forget adding some casted shadows. So, I just put some tonal dark color, and here, let's put some. These shadows. And then let's put some highlights. Okay, so I'm gonna use this brush, everyone. It's a bristle flat brush. I'm gonna use this blue on the yellow, yellow on blue, a little bit of red, more blue. after it slowly, like that. Put it on the top, everyone. Make sure that the paint is thick enough. Okay, I'm gonna make it thicker. So, we have now a beautiful tree. And then we're gonna put the highlights on the top. Just white and the yellow. Okay, that looks good, I think. Yeah, it looks like a beautiful big tree. Okay. I also want to put some brownish color on the tree, everyone. Yeah. So I have here the red and the yellow, which blue umber or yellow. Okay, not just that's it. And I'm gonna make the tree trunk a little bit lighter. So I will be using this small brush. So raw umber and the white. Okay, yeah, I think this is a beautiful tree, everyone. It looks pretty realistic. Damn. I think I'm gonna put some darks here more. Also some lights here. Okay. So I think I'm gonna put some more highlights on the back. So I have here the yellow. A little bit of orange.
it's a golden fruit.
These three more. So yeah, I'm gonna use this. I'm gonna add more greens. Wait, it's still too light. Yeah. Okay, and also here. There you go. So you have now a beautiful tree there on the sides. Here, everyone, I'm gonna try to put a little bit lights on the river. So, yeah, maybe just a plain white. Then we're going to put some highlights here. Okay, so we'll try some more, but I'm going to add some white, yellow. Okay. So just a tapping technique, everyone. You can create this beautiful grasses. There. I'll put first some white. White will make everything bright. Just drag it down, something like that. There. And also here. Okay, some yellow. Just just drag it down like that. Okay, and then I'll try some greenish. Okay, low on the blue. Looks good. Okay, and here everyone, I'm gonna try to put some a little bit of small, or here a little bit of a bunk or river bunk, just white and amber. A bit of dark. There. Protein. Go. And I will try some dark greens. This part. Or some greens. And then I'm gonna try to mix for dark greenish for the water reflections here. Just drag it down like that, everyone. And then also some browns here. And then some greenish. On the top of the mountain. Yeah.
in here, I'm gonna make it bright here.
So just light brown, everyone. Raw amber yellow and the red. Maybe a little bit more bright. So I'm gonna use a smaller brush now. I'm gonna adjust white or orange. Some white also, plain white. There. And then, I will try to use some light blue. So here, everyone, I'm gonna try to put some water disturbance, water waves. And also here, I'll try to reach out. There. So, it looks real water now. Even just simple steps, we can create a beautiful realistic water. So it looks good. Everything looks good, everyone. It's just simple landscape, but it looks realistic for me, and from that we create or we give justice to our painting. So yeah, we are successful in that. And here, the last part, I will just put some few grasses here with the bigger leaves gloss up to us like that. So I will be using this small round brush. We got some blue, amber blue, and the red. And then we will use this medium size, a small flat brush. So first, we will create the light green. Or more like yellow greens. maybe more. And then I'm gonna try to use some white. And then we're gonna use this blue and the yellow for some greens. I'm gonna put some red to make it more look mature. I'm going to put more blue, red, and the yellow.
It's a dark green, everyone.
Okay. So slowly, everyone,
develop the tones. So we are starting with light colors because the sunlight is in the back of this on the top back of this this mountain. So
we are putting, we did at first the darks, and then the lights, and then slowly we add the darks. Because mostly the dark in the front of us. And then we will add now the light blues or the blue greens, more like a bluish color. There, a little bit of yellow. Color is a little bit cold compared to the yellow greens. From doing that way, the color will become much more realistic. Now let's put some highlights. There you go. Yeah, that looks good, and it looks pretty realistic for me. The colors is great, and it looks realistic. Plants there. Yeah, the view overall is just very, very simple, but it looks good. So I'll just try to retouch, and I think I'll be finished. Okay. So I don't know if I'm going to put a horse there. I'm not sure. Yeah, maybe I will put the horse there on the same dark part. I think it will be good. I'll try to imagine how it will look like. I think I'll put a horse there that is like climbing on the on the mountain. Yeah, I'll do like that. Here. Okay, just very, very easy and simple. It will add life to our painting, so it's very, very important. So yeah, I'll just use this rubber. I'm using the small brush everywhere. Thank you. is like eating some grass. I think that looks like a horse. And then let's try to put some highlights. I'm gonna use red and yellow. Try to put some red here. Put on my part. There. Some lights. I think that's better. Yeah, there's a shadow girl because he's in the back of this part. Okay, so I'll let you see everything and let's finish. I think I will try to, maybe I will try to make the bigger. I'm not sure if it's right or not. Here. Okay, so I'm going to retouch a little bit and I think I have finished. Okay, so put some highlights, more highlights. So I have here yellow with a little bit of red. Try some yellow. To make it more solid here. And then a little bit of white. let's see. We'll just put some orange and banana to it and we'll be finished. Okay, so everyone, I think I am done, and I hope that you enjoy the entire tutorial. I hope that you like the result. I also love the result. It's just so simple, everyone, and it looks great for me. It's just a little bit of easy. I think this is very easy for everyone who wants to learn painting realistic simple landscape. So everything looks so simple. Everything, I think you can also do this. Even just simple objects there, simple shapes, and you just have to put shades there, lights, and it will turn out realistic landscape. So yeah, I hope you are learning by these simple steps, and so that you can also create your own landscape beautiful.
Okay everyone, so I want to say thank you for watching this video today, and I hope you get something out of this. And my only advice is to keep on practicing, keep on painting. The more you do it, the more you know how to use your brush, the more you will know how to mix the colors. That's why I'm using limited colors in my palette, because I want you to learn how to mix and get the desired colors you want. So please hit like, add some comments, subscribe for more videos in the future. Okay, once again, thank you. Have a nice day, and God bless you all. All the glory and honor and praises always belongs to the Lord.